Hey, what's up? Sam here. I have reviewed some 3D printers. Today, I'd like to introduce you two special 3D printers. This one is the perfect one for kids, where this one is the only machine that can print these materials. When I check out the more, let's dive into it. First, let's check out the small one. I think in order to make a good 3D printer for children, there are two basic requirements, simplicity and safety. You cannot just shrink a normal 3D printer to a smaller size and call it a kid's 3D printer, right? I think the Mixware Wand meets all of those demands and can do even more. Starting from unboxing, first we see some paperwork including a sensor thank you later and an English manual. Then we have the first layer that includes some accessories and of course the lightweight one 3D printer. If you are curious to know what the accessories are, they include a spool holder, a USB cable, some Allen keys, a USB disk, a 250g load of filament, a pair of cutting pliers, and a spade. By the way, don't forget to take out the other box that's inside the printer, which includes the power cable and adapter. Before we get down to the printing, let me walk you very quickly through the design. On the front left, we have the filament loading or unloading button, a printing button in the middle, and an auto leveling button on the right, and of course, the door. On one side, we have a USB port and a data transfer port. On the other side, we have the power port and a power button. As for the top, sure, we have the nozzle. Yes, that's it. That's basically the design. To use the printer, I think it's easy enough. First, we insert a spool holder to the slot and rotate it to fix it. Then we take out the filament and cut one end to the point, obviously for easier pushing to the extruder. After that, we load the filament to the extruder until it extends several meters into the white pipe. We connect the power and make sure the flat cables are upward before starting to print, because as the nozzle moves back and forth, you have to make sure nothing interferes with it. Finally, we are able to move on to preparing the files, namely slicing. This maybe sounds complicated, but luckily Mixware includes 10 selected models on the disk you can use, or if you want to try some other models, they have their own Mixware slicer software for you to prepare printing files. This app is based on the most widely used art maker Cura software, but made better to fit its 3D printers. Here I'm not going to do a detailed explanation of that, otherwise this video would be endless, but I believe it wouldn't be an issue as long as you follow steps, because that's quite standard for the 3D printing slicing process. Here I will just use a test file to print one sample to demo all the printing steps. You plug in the USB disk to the printer, turn on the power, press once on the auto leveling and then the middle button. At this time, the Mixware Wand enters the self-leveling process. It takes about 2.5 minutes. All you need to do is have a cup of coffee or watch some TikTok videos. After that, press the filament loading button and the middle button to let the machine load the filament by itself. This takes about 4 minutes. You will see the filament moving towards the nozzle and the pipe. Again, it doesn't require you to do anything at this step. After that, you get rid of the testing filament on the plate. Then hold on the middle button for 2 seconds to start printing. Finally, it's printing. The test model took me about 25 minutes. After printing, you can take out the plate and get your artwork. You can either use a spade or just by hand like Simi to remove it from the support. One great thing I found is that even if during printing I deliberately move it or shake it, it can still print something accurate. Even Simi's cat likes it. And of course, my daughter is absolutely happy about it. The print quality is awesome. It did a good job in rendering fine detail on different objects. The details are just great. It makes you feel this is not 3D printed. Though it takes some time to learn, to get familiar with if you are totally new to 3D printing, and I guess for kids they still need to be under the guidance of adults. It is still the easiest 3D printer to use according to my experience. The Mixware Wand has got rid of some of the tedious parts like assembly and especially the leveling. Now it's fully automatic. And also the maintenance, no need to pay attention like other printers. The most difficult part is to use the software for slicing. Good news is that Mixware told us that they are developing a mobile app which allows kids to draw 3D models right on the app and print directly. That looks really eye-catching and could reduce the difficulty significantly. To be honest, I really appreciate that finally there's a company that's willing to do that. Like I said in the beginning of this video, safety is another important factor for kids' 3D printers. The Mixware Wand is wrapped in a box. Great way to prevent kids or even your pets from touching the nozzle. Of course, if you are looking for a normal size 3D printer that's improving your productivity, Mixware has got it covered too. Mixware also sent Simi and I their Hyper S, a super high temperature 3D printer. This is what it includes in the box. Here I'm not going to show every detail of how to install or use it. Compared to 3D printers I've reviewed before, here are some details from the Mixware I really like. In order to install the gantry easily, Mixware has placed two position pins there, so just slide into the frame, and then tighten it by using four screws. They also come with two rods for better stabilization. The Hyper S has a 3.5-inch LCD touchable screen, which is super great. You can choose everything there, and it also has a filament detection module. Regarding using the Hyper S, it's easier too, like leveling. You can just choose water leveling and then the machine does the work. What you need to do is adjust the Z-axis a bit, which saves tons of work compared to a normal 3D printer. Well, for filament loading or slicing, it's the same as normal 3D printing. What I can see here is Mixware is trying to simplify things that's possible now. If you are new, what I recommend is read the manual thoroughly and follow the steps. As for 3D modeling, you can even find more tutorials online for better results. Again, I don't think it's difficult to learn, just have a little patience. And it's rewarding, because the moment you see the results, you knew that. The print quality was uniformly superb, they look very nice and sharp with good definition. None of the finished prints had any significant problems, and many showed no visible flaws. Not only for those normal filaments, it also supports nylon copper fiber, high-temp nylon, and even TPU. Yes, that soft material. You can print some extra small or super large. I love it! With an under $500 price, Mixware made no compromises on the performance or quality. No complicated setups here and there, the Hyper S performs like a boss. Print only a variety of objects with no misprints or good handling of detail, whether for hard or soft material. Alright, that's the video. So what do you think of these two machines? Do you think this Mixware Wand is the perfect one for your kid? At least I think it is so. You can print some really cute stuff for your kid, and I'm sure your kid will love it. Well, for this Mixware Hyper S, it can really print a wide range of materials. So what will you do with this, with them? Let me know down in the comments below. And if you are interested in this two products, you can check out the link in the description. Currently it's on crowdfunding campaign and they offer the best price. Yeah, that's the video. Thanks for watching, I'll see you in the next.